Did you know the story of the first freedom fighter of India? This is Hi, I'm Abhi and I want to tell you the story of a badass that no history book has ever told you before. This is Chennamma of Kittur.
In short, she's the Rani Lakshmibai of the South and her story is very inspiring.
She was the first Indian to lead an armed rebellion against the East India Company. We've been taught about the uprising of 1857. This happened 33 years before that. Here's why. Chennamma was a badass, like a real badass.
At the age of 15, she got married to the king of Kittur and had a son. But the king died and so did the prince, the only heir to the Kittur throne.
Chennamma adopted a boy and named him the heir. And that's when the East India Company came with a devious plan to take over the kingdom, not with arms, but with a piece of paper. Basically, if your kingdom has no male heir by birth, it's taken over by the self-proclaimed saviors, East India Company. Why? I don't know. Don't ask me. ये East India Company कौन है? कहां से आई है? Who gave them the right to make these nonsense rules?
But Chennamma said no. She refused to give up. It was time for war. The British East India Company attacked Kittur with 20,000 men and 400 guns.
They had the numbers, Chennamma had the will. Chennamma crushed the British. She captured two British officers and beheaded a collector. Like I told you, badass. This was the first defeat in India for the British. It was a major blow to their self-inflated ego. Chennamma promised to return the British hostages if the East India Company promised to leave Kittur alone.
Leave Kittur alone? Is that too much to ask for? The British accepted the truce, took back the officers, but attacked again in 3 months, with more army from the outside and a little help from the inside.
The warrior queen was betrayed. Her very own generals conspired against her and mixed cow dung with gunpowder. Her cannons failed and Kittur lost. This is the ruin of Kittur Palace. It's impossible to believe that this place once had unimaginable wealth. This story is a representation of why British were able to control India. In the British Raj, there were 100,000 Britishers and 30 million Indians. 30 million Indians, and yet they were able to control us, rule us and loot us. Why? Because of one reason only. It's easy to divide Indians. I don't know how. But we Indians have this unique ability of believing an outsider and not our own people. Think about it. Chennamma's story is still relevant because we are still not united. We like to pull each other down and we cannot digest the success of our fellow Indians. Chennamma ka naam itihas ke pannon mein kahin kho gaya hai. But I feel her story needs to be remembered. Drop a yes if you think that her story needs to be told. There are so many freedom fighters whose story is lost in time. Tell me which one would you like to hear next. Our history is full of these lessons we still need to learn. And that's the reason why
I love India.